give another one, go to the hospital. Doctor diagnoses you with stuff. Someone comes and says, how did you go in the hospital? Say, that doctor said my enemy has so and so. Now, number one, if you repent for lying, God will forgive you. The doctor did not say your enemy has. You know, some people think that faith just is a denial of facts. There's nothing wrong with stating the fact. Jesus did not say, whosoever shall say there's no mountain. He said, whosoever shall say unto this mountain. So it's not wrong to identify the mountain. You understand? But you see, we are so afraid of it. People have heard, don't be negative, don't be negative, don't be negative. So they're just trying not to be negative. But they don't believe what they are saying. And they don't realize that it's destroying their faith. Are you listening to me? Yeah, the weak should say I'm strong. But they shouldn't only say it, they should act it. So if you say I'm strong, you have to believe that. And then you have to act I'm strong. You know, you hear somebody say, ah, my brother, can you lend me some money? I'm very rich this month. You know, you're deceiving your heart. If you want to say, can you lend me some money? It's not a sin to say, my guy, I'm quite low on cash, so I need some help. Can you lend me some money? After all, billionaires sometimes, they have their monies in investments. So that sometimes they're just not so liquid at that moment. Is it possible? You know, sometimes after school, somebody goes to meet somebody, says, ah, my friend, how far? I'm very rich, Joe. Can you give me some money so I can get home? You know? Listen, if somebody comes to tell you that, tell them, well, since you are rich, you better start going home. They are just afraid. It's like, don't say something negative. Don't say something. Look, it's not about don't say something negative. It's about speak the word of God and believe what you say. If what you want to do is to beg for money, and there may be a place where a body, we care for one another. There's a place to say, my guy, I'm not holding cash, I'm a little down on cash. I need some help. Can you help me with a little money to get home? That's fine. But don't go and say, I am rich. If what you want to say is, I am rich, then act I am rich and don't go and beg. Rich people act rich. They don't ask for money. If you want to ask for money and say, well, I'm not holding money. But don't say, I'm rich. You know, we keep saying those kind of things and we are deceiving our hearts. I give another one. Go to the hospital. Doctor diagnoses you with stuff. Someone comes and says, how did you go in the hospital? Say, that doctor said my enemy has so and so. Now, number one, if you repent for lying, God will forgive you. The doctor did not say your enemy has. You know, some people think that faith just is a denial of facts. There's nothing wrong with stating the fact. Jesus did not say, whosoever shall say there's no mountain. He said, whosoever shall say unto this mountain. So it's not wrong to identify the mountain. You say, well, I went to the doctor. The doctor's report wasn't positive. From what he saw, this was what was diagnosed. However, I know from the word of God that himself took my infirmities and bare my sicknesses. The word of God says, by his stripes I'm healed. And I'm just going to believe God's word. You see, Paul said, we are troubled on every side. Are you listening? He said, but not distressed. He said, we're persecuted, but not forsaken. He said, we're perplexed, but not in despair. He said, we're cast down, but not destroyed. He didn't deny the fact that he was persecuted, that he was cast down, that he was perplexed. He didn't deny those facts. He said, right into the church at Corinth, the same church, he said, God had set before me an open door, and there are many adversaries. He didn't deny there were adversaries. Are you listening to me? So we should speak the word of God. Where I'm coming to is this. Learn to believe what you say. If you don't believe what you say, you're going to deceive your heart. The forces of your life come out of your heart. You know, you went to meet somebody to beg for money. You told him, I am rich. Your spirit heard you. This guy is acting, I'm poor, but what he said is, I'm rich. Maybe that's how he talks. Okay. You call to say, I won't be able to come. You say, I'm strong. Your spirit heard you. He said, I'm strong. And really, what he meant is, I'm weak. Okay. Later, you're now confessing, I'm more than a conqueror through him that loved me. Your spirit will say, you know, when he says, I'm strong, it means I'm weak. When he says, I'm rich. It means I'm poor. Now that he's saying I'm more than a conqueror, you see, what he really means is I'm defeated. So that's what your spirit is going to act on. Are you listening? Watch what you say. Your words will register on your spirit. And don't tell lies. If you tell lies, you destroy your spirit. If you don't mean it, don't say it. Say what you mean. Mean what you say. The forces of your life come out of your spirit. So speak the word of God into your spirit. You know, sometimes people say, well, I'm just trying to be nice. No, you're not. You're being devilish. Now, I'm not saying you should injure people with your words. Somebody comes to see you, you say, well, I'm not glad to see you. I actually wanted to rest today. I wonder what you're doing, disturbing me this time of the day. You know, it's my day off, or this is weekend. Why are you coming? Now, I'm not saying you should be offensive, but that's how you really stand about it. The person that comes, say, ah, my guy, how now? So glad to see you. You know, sometimes you wonder why our children have trouble with us, because they knew what you said in the house. Yeah. Have you seen children who go and tell a visitor that daddy said he's not around? My daddy said I should tell you that he's sleeping. Those kids are innocent. Look, say what you mean. Say what you mean. Watch what you say. Speak the word of God into your heart. By speaking God's word, it will register on your spirit. And once God's word registers on your spirit, that's what you're going to get. Because your spirit will see to it, will look for ways, creative and otherwise, such that the things you are saying will come to pass. If you keep saying, well, I'm compassed with favor as a shield, the day you go to the embassy for an interview, you know, it will just so happen that that difficult consular officer will be the one that will, you have a flat tire when he's coming. That day, yeah, I'm not praying that he has one, but your spirit will see to it that you have what you say. Your spirit will see to it that you'll be with the right person. Your spirit will see to it that, you know, you meet the right people at the right time. You'll be consciously and unconsciously led, because it will see to it that what is in it will come out. The forces of your life come out of your heart. Well, number 6, confession works, because that's how we set the law of faith in motion. Confession works because that's how we set the law of faith in motion. In Romans chapter 3, verse 27, the Bible says, where is boasting then? It is excluded. How is it excluded? By what law? Of works? Is it excluded by the law of works? He said, no, but by the law of faith. So, boasting is excluded. How is it excluded? By the law of faith. To get the full import of what Romans 3:27 is saying, you need to start from verse 21. The righteousness of God without the law is manifest, being witnessed by the law and the prophets, even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all them that believe, for there is no difference. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God hath set forth to be a propitiation through faith in his blood, to declare his righteousness for the remission of the sins that are passed through the forbearance of God. To declare, say at this time, his righteousness, that he might be righteous, that he might be just, and the righteousness of them that have faith in Jesus. He now says, where is boasting then? So you see, the context of Romans 3:27 is talking about the righteousness which is of faith, and how that it is not through our works that we got saved, but through the righteousness which is of faith. So Romans 3:27 tells us that there is a law to faith. There is a law to faith. Now, what context is this speaking of in relation to salvation? How did we get saved? What's that law? Romans 10, 9 and 10, that if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So you see, we became the righteousness of God, the righteousness which is of faith. This is what it says, that the word is near us. So we got saved by believing in our hearts and confessing with our mouths. Listen, that's the law of faith. That's the law of faith. Same principle that we find in Mark 11, 23. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever, anybody, anywhere, tall or short, fat or slim, you know, beautiful or ugly, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he saith shall come to pass. He shall have whatsoever he saith. Now, Jesus ended Mark 11:23 by saying he shall have whatsoever he saith. Notice, Jesus did not say he shall have whatsoever he saith to the mountain. Jesus said he shall have whatsoever he saith. So whether he's saying to the mountain, saying about the mountain, saying about anything else, about the valley, saying about the tree, he shall have whatsoever he saith, provided he believes in his heart that what he says will come to pass. Now, how do we set that law of faith in motion? It's by speaking. It's by speaking. So that's another reason why confession works. Because that's the way we set the law of faith in motion, by speaking. You see, the devil is not afraid of what you believe, if that's all you do with it. If you don't act on what you believe, it means nothing to the devil. He doesn't mind you believing all you can, if that's all you do. If that's all you do.